Hey guys, Tasha here from Stardust Gold Crochet. Welcome to the Fair Isle Crochet Along. This is video for week one, part two. So what we're gonna go over for this video, and just keep watching, it's gonna be at the end of the video, is we're gonna go over how to read a graph and why these hooks, or why the hook makes a difference for this pattern, and using in creating the waistcoat and knit stitch. So when you learn how to read a graph, I'm gonna go through an actual program called WinStitch, and WinStitch is really great. It spits out your written pattern, so you can create graphs with beanies that have. You can create beanies for you guys. You can create graphs for beanies, and it's really awesome, and you're gonna become addicted to it. I just know it. So keep watching, and I hope you guys have a great crochet along with me. Excuse my fumbling words, but I think in one of my podcasts I mentioned that I tend to fumble my words a lot. I'm learning. I'll do it eventually, but all right, so keep watching. Let's learn together. All right, here we are, and we're gonna learn how to read the graph for the Fair Isle crochet along. This is the graph I created. It's a snowflake graph with just a few other elements in there. I created this using the program WinStitch, which is a great program if you wanna learn how to create graphs. It does take a little bit of practice and learning a few techniques, but I'm gonna post a video on WinStitch and how to use WinStitch to create your own graphs for hat patterns or Fair Isle style sweaters. You can do so many great things once you learn how to read and create graphs. It's beautiful. So let's get started on this one. We're gonna do our pattern working from the bottom to the top of the graph. We're going to work from right to left. Our pattern repeats 90 stitches long. So each stitch represents one square of your pattern. So each little square represents your stitch and which color you're going to be using. So we got a red, a white, red, white stitch, etc. Each row is a row of crochet, or a row or a round in our case. So we're gonna be working from right to left. We work our 30 stitches, we come right back and we start repeating our pattern until we have 90 for the adult size or 60 for the toddler size. So that's what it is, basically. You just keep going up and up. I always usually scratch off or mark off my rows as I work. And so that's how we're gonna work this pattern. And reading a graph really isn't that hard. Some of them might be more difficult for row by rows, but I'll go over that in the other video that I post up for WinStitch. Okay, so these hooks. This is the hooks that I was talking about in the video before. These are two boy style hooks I have over here. This is an inline hook, a Susan Bates hook. These are my favorite kind of hooks for most every other project I work on, except for Fair Isle or changing colors, because I learned my lesson and got a callus on my thumb using an inline hook. So the difference between an inline and a tapered boy hook, these are called tapered, this is called inline. The reason they call it that is you can pretty much see the difference. This is a tapered, in line, because it's in line. The whole way up is the same width. So you get the same, your hole opening for your crochet is the exact same, no matter where you go or how you stick your hook in. Unfortunately, for tapered hooks, that doesn't happen. So gauge is always gonna be a little bit different, and your tension might be a little bit different when you use a tapered hook. Tapered means that it tapers up like this. So you can see it's 6 millimeters around until it gets to right about here, and then it starts to get really thin. So I think these are better for more advanced crocheters. These are great for beginners and for fast crocheters. Also tapered hooks, you have to angle them slightly at an angle when you're working. And inline hooks, you don't have to angle at all. You can pull through pretty much at any angle, which is why I love them too. But for this project, I found this hook to work the best for me, which is a boy style hook. It's ergonomic, and it also has a really
nice tip to it that was able to grab onto that right leg of the V stitch of the single crochet, and you just grab onto it and then angle it better, and it has a nice tip to it. So pick whichever hook works best for you guys, and then you know, practice your gauge swatch a little bit, see which one works. We're going to work on changing colors for the next video, and we're also going to learn the knit stitch on the next video, which is going to be Friday. So I'm going to go over and post a little bit about how to do wind stitch, so you guys can learn how to actually create graphs yourself too. So you can create tons of things. I've kind of come up with a formula for this, actually. Using worsted weight yarn, you can do a graph like this, and it seems that about 90 stitches works best if you're going to do a graph like this using a ferro, or if you're using a 30 stitch pattern. So you can always come up with a 30 stitch or a 10 stitch. 10 stitch patterns, when I say 10 stitch, I mean 10 squares. So 10 squares works great for hats that have a bulkier yarn. Like I did a couple Country Hearts beanie, and also the, what other one did I do? The two of my chunky beanies, those will work in 10 square patterns. So anyway, we'll get into that in the next video. So if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, head on over to the blog and leave a comment, or on my Facebook page. Sorry guys, my dogs are barking. Yeah, leave all that stuff. You guys know what to do. I'll see you soon.